Joining me right now is California Congressman, ranking member of the Select Committee on Intelligence, Representative Devin Nunes. Congressman, it's always a pleasure to see you.
Great to be with you.
Thanks so much for joining us. How would you characterize the impeachment inquiry, number one?
Well, it's really an investigation in search of a crime. So the Russia hoax failed. Now they've moved on to the Ukraine hoax. Even after Mueller came out, they continued with the Russia hoax. And then they concocted something with people that they clearly have an alliance with, meaning that the whistleblower was working with Schiff and his people on the committee. And now, look, nobody even they don't even want to interview the whistleblower. They've said that we don't have to interview the whistleblower. So none of this really makes any sense. I think it's just a matter of time before the American people will start to realize that this is just the Russia hoax 2.0.
But little by little, things are leaking out in corners of, and at one point it leaked out that you, because you were in all of these closed-door testimonies, you interviewed Ambassador Sondland, and you took it back to the origins of the Russia probe.
Yeah, and they didn't like that because, you know, when you state the obvious, okay, which is that the Democrats were heavily engaged in paying foreigners to get dirt on Trump. They don't like that, even though it's well documented that they paid Fusion GPS, who paid a spy, who got information from Ukraine, no less. And so they don't like when we bring up, wait a second, you were the guys that were getting information from Ukraine. So I always say that Rudy Giuliani and the president, they have nothing to apologize for. They had every right to be in Ukraine trying to figure out who were the Ukrainians that were giving dirt to the Democrats on him.
And you've been investigating the origins of the Russia probe now for 3 years or so. In terms of...
And they begin in Ukraine.
Do you think we're going to see the IG report soon on this, by the way?
I hope so. The sooner the better. It's evidence, what I understand is, I mean, if you can believe what's in some of the news reports, but seems like the IG report is finished and now just awaiting declassification.
Censoring Adam Schiff, what does that mean? And now it's being tabled, right? The Democrats do not want to even vote on any censoring of Adam Schiff, obviously.
Right. So tonight we'll vote on the censure motion that Mr. Biggs introduced and that Leader McCarthy is supporting for the Republicans. The Democrats don't want to debate this measure, so likely what's going to happen tonight when we move to bring it up, they will do what's called tabling, which is a way to push it off and so that we don't have to debate it. They don't want to have to debate why they were making things up, right, in front of committee, why they were putting words in the president's mouth. They don't want to have to debate why they were meeting with the whistleblower. They don't want to have to debate why they are doing things in secret. They don't want to have to debate why they're leaking things. I can continue, but the bottom line is that it'll probably be on a party line vote. But we'll just continue to bring pressure as we can.
Do people understand this, that all of this is going on behind closed doors? And this is, I mean, because, you know, they're continuing this impeachment, whatever you want to call it, inquiry show.
I think the real question is ultimately the people who don't pay attention, people who aren't watching your show on a daily basis or the other shows, you know, it's that middle part of America, right, who are just, you know, they're taking their kids to school right now, they're dropping them off, they may hear, you know, pick up a little bit on the radio or see something as they're walking out to work. Those are the people that really matter. So I think that's why you see a little bit of a high right now in a lot of these polls on impeachment. But once people begin to realize, wait a second, these are just shenanigans, same old shenanigans that occur in the swamp, that polling will start to go down.
Well, they're also looking at Twitter. They're looking at Google. You are right. Suing Twitter for negligence. You're seeking $250 million in damages for alleged bias and ignoring abusive behavior. Tell me about the suit. And you did get a victory 2 weeks ago from a judge.
Yeah, we got a victory, but Twitter is now refusing to follow the court order. The judge was very clear that discovery needs to begin. And now they're refusing to give us these bot farm accounts. Okay, so remember, we're looking at, there's many bots that are out there and fake anonymous accounts that are attacking me virtually by the second. Okay?
They attacked your mother.
They're right. They've attacked my mother. They've attacked my family. They've attacked my staff. They've attacked my lawyer. And look, the key here is we're politicians. It's fine to attack us, but it's not okay to slander us. Right? It's not okay to impersonate someone else. And that's the case here. And what these are is that one is a smaller bot farm. You know, we don't know exactly how many bots one group controls. And then there's another larger bot farm, we believe. And they refuse to give us, we can't even get these people into court because we can't figure out who's behind them. And I'll tell you, you know, this has been 6 months now. We filed this in March. Twitter has basically proven negligence, okay, because they have a responsibility to come clean and tell us, because, you know, they could have easily got out of this case and not been part of the negligence part if they just would have come forward and said, wait, sorry, we didn't know these bot farms were here.
Right.
We understand they're doing defamation and slandering and death threats. We don't want to be in this business. We don't want to take part in this, okay? They refused to do that, and now they're at a point where, you know, this is really fraud on the market, if you really think about it, because the board members and the executives at Twitter, they have a responsibility to their shareholders, their mom and pops who own shares in these companies, right? The IRAs out there. And if they're not telling their shareholders that they have a bunch of bot farms out there, I mean, think about the advertising dollars. And I think I don't own Twitter stock, but if someone did, you could easily bring a fraud case against
them. Now, when I spoke to you yesterday, you said it could be securities fraud.
Yeah.
I want to ask you, because basically what you're saying is there's all of these robot accounts, you call them bots, robot accounts, and you think that there's robot farms which are owned or operated by political campaigns or what?
Well, remember, it was the Democrats and the left, okay, who complained about the bot farms. They said that Trump only won because of Russian bot farms. You had Hillary Clinton yesterday accuse Tulsi Gabbard of having bot farms. Well, we know that there are bot farms out there with anonymous accounts that attack me. Twitter knows it. Okay?
And you say that they're
Twitter
selling advertising based
they're
on
They're selling
those
advertising based on those
And that's
numbers.
Where you come up with securities fraud.
That's one issue, all right? So, you know, what percentage of the accounts out there are actually just fake accounts, right, that are just really some guy sitting in his underwear somewhere in his basement with 50 accounts that he sits all day on the computer attacking someone or some group or some party.
And some political group is running.
And here's their big problem that they're not being honest about. When prominent Democrats have bot farms or even parody accounts that are built on them, they get taken down almost immediately, okay? But with me, here we are in court, and they're so negligent and so arrogant that now I think they're putting their own company in danger.
Wow. All right, real quick, what's the next step here?
Well, we have to go to court now to get the judge to compel them. So we made a motion to compel so that we can get on with the case. The judge already ruled the case is going to be heard. I have a right to be heard. And they have to defend themselves, and they don't get to defend themselves by just refusing to tell us where these bot farms and anonymous accounts are located.
All right, we will be watching this, Congressman. Thank you for
Always a pleasure.
Giving us the update here on Twitter. Congressman Devin Nunes, we will see you soon, sir.